in the article, The Academic Pipeline, they talk about reasons why women might self-select away from going into academia. Part of those include family obligations and this idea that academia is not compatible with family relations. And I understand that this is true to a certain extent. There's a lot of discussion about when you can have children in academia. The idea is basically you either have to have them before you go into grad school or after your tenure, because there's a whole time in the middle that it's harder to have children, because you don't want to do it while you're doing your dissertation because it'll be distracting. It's hard to do while you're on the job market, both for reasons of discrimination. If you have young children, the idea, even if not explicitly, the idea might be that you might have a harder time getting a job because they might be more reluctant to hire you because of time off issues, same as in the greater workforce, general understanding of parenthood. And then when you're early in your career, you have to do so much publishing and research and teaching that it would be hard to start a family at that point. So the idea is if you don't already have a family started, then it's more difficult to start at certain points in your career. After tenure, of course, you have a little more freedom, but then you're also older, so there are biological issues at that point. I agree with those things. But I also, part of the reason I like the idea of academia is that the schedule is a lot more flexible than a traditional 9-to-5. So in my mind, if I do have kids, I do intend to work throughout my adulthood. I don't plan to stay home with children, but I do like the idea of being able to have flexible time so I can see if I decide to have children, that I could see them at a certain point, which is not something they discussed in the article. So this would definitely take time away from other things, but since you can work from home with your research and you can have a more flexible schedule, maybe only be on campus 2 or 3 days a week instead of 5 days a week, and then only for a couple of hours, so that you have a more flexible time frame and location of where you work, that seems a little more compatible than, say, the business world, where you actually have to be in the office at least 5 days a week, at least 8 hours a day, that sort of thing. This is probably a very naive concept of parenting in academia, but I'd like to keep it for now because I do want to pursue both my academic career and maybe eventually a family.
For my last interview, I chose Janice Baldwin, a professor of sociology at UCSB. Janice is well known at UC Santa Barbara for teaching the Sociology 152 series with her husband John. Her contribution to the project is unique for two reasons. There was a significant gap between the time she completed her undergraduate and graduate degrees, and because she is the only one of my interviewees who has completed her graduate schooling and is working in academia.
Yeah, I first went to graduate school in the 1980s after I'd been working as an academic for a long time, studying monkeys in Central and South America, and working on writing projects and also teaching at the university, that I realized I needed an advanced degree. So I got an advanced degree and became a full-fledged academic, continued publishing and continued working in the areas of my greatest interest. And my greatest interest is women's reproductive rights. And that's what I worked before I got my PhD, and I've worked for that since I've had my PhD. And I've always felt like every woman deserves to be able to control her own body. You know, I didn't realize it when I graduated from college that was something controversial, because I graduated from college decades ago, of course, and I thought that this would just be, you know, something that would be there, that every woman would have. And it's quite surprising to realize that at the time nobody even thought of that, and that people get very upset by it, and that still today there are billions of women that have no control over their own bodies. And I don't just want it for women either, because I think it's essential for men. I think it's important for both sexes to have control over their own bodies. You know, at this day and age, to not be victims of our biology, but because we do have a brain that we can use to have children when and if we want to have children, rather than to have forced reproduction. So reproductive rights have been a crucial, crucial importance to me.
After this portion of my talk with Janice, I realized that my project was taking on a life of its own. Though I never intended to focus only on the interaction between childbearing and academia, the data I had gathered so far was directing me to it. Janice was different from my other interviewees in that she has not had children and doesn't intend to. I wondered what her reasons for foregoing parenthood were.
Having children is really important to many, many women, and they do plan their lives around it. And yes, of course, having better child care facilities would be good. Our university has child care facilities many women do use, but there's an interesting study relevant to that at universities, because many universities do give parental leave, and which men or women can take leave. And they found that the men, when they were on leave, they would use this time. They have the baby there, but the baby was secondary. They didn't really want to take that much care of the baby. They'd use it to advance their career and do more writing. But the women, when they took their leave for the baby, they used it to take care of the baby. And there's just been such a different socialization for women to really care about caring for babies. And men haven't had that same socialization. I'm not saying all men and all women, I'm saying proportionally more women have been more baby-oriented. And since, for some reason, not sure why, I can trace it back, I have many hypotheses, I haven't felt like I had to have children, so that was never a factor for me in entering academia or in planning my life. I've actually had an unusual life because I've done other things besides being academic, and many people in academia just do academia. And so I've had the freedom to explore other areas and have other interests. And I don't mean just as avocations, I mean as vocations. It's been exciting to have that freedom. I think academia provides more freedom than women realize, and I think honestly it's a great shame that women think they have to plan their life around children, because I think that all the professions, you can have children and still have the profession, and I don't think women really appreciate that. But then also there are women that want to take care of their children, and that's a perfectly noble goal. There's nothing wrong with wanting to take care of your children. If this is your goal in life and you have the desire to stay home with your children, I personally don't want to put that down. I think that raising children for those women who choose to do it full time is a great profession. I think more people should think of it as a profession, and instead of, well, I've got these kids to take care of. Raising kids is a very, very important job to do in the world.
As I reviewed the material that I had gotten from my interviews, I began to think about what it meant for me. I was forced to think more about the details involved in childbearing, and what it might mean for both men and women, whether they were in academia or not. One of the articles I came across in my research indicated that men and women think about childbearing differently. While men tend to think of it as something that will just happen, women are more aware that it is something that must be planned for. I can attest to the truth of half of this statement, as I intend to have children, but have never really thought about how that will fit in with the rest of my life. After speaking with each of these women, I see that there are many ways to plan childbirth. A person could delay having children until they have developed a career, they could find a career that allows them to raise children and work at the same time, or they could simply choose not to have children. Whatever path a person or couple may choose to take, both men and women should know that there are many ways to mix raising a child with having a career.